Good evening, everyone. I'm Jackie Nespral.
And I'm Trina Robinson with Adam Kuperstein. He's joining us live from the campus of Nova Southeastern University tonight.
He's on day three of the NBC-6 College Week Tour. Hi, Adam.
Hey, Jackie. Hey, Trina. This school, Nova Southeastern University in Davie, is 28,000 strong. I think half the school made it out here today for College Week on NBC6. We got the cheerleaders. The students are doing their fins up sign for the Sharks. The basketball team is here. We've even got a DJ. It's going to be a lot of fun today. We're also going to teach you a lot about what makes this school so special. A huge educational program. Also, they have a dental school that's helping South Floridians spend save a lot of money on their dental work. And on top of that, some students here get to spend a lot of their time in class underwater. That's all coming up on College Week on NBC6. Right now, let's go back inside the studio for today's news.
And Adam will be tweeting from the campus throughout the 90 minutes of news, so you can join him using the hashtag NSUon6.
I'm Adam Kuperstein, live at Nova Southeastern University in Davie. And coming up, I'm going to show you how some of the students here at Nova Southeastern are making sure our South Florida beaches stay as beautiful as they are. And you got to see this. Joe Rose is here for sports. Right now, he's working the DJ turntables. I kid you not, Joe Rose has taken over on the DJ table. That can't be a good thing for Nova Southeastern. We're back after this.
You hear that music and you know it's College Week. Well, today's stop on the NBC6 College Week Tour takes us to Nova Southeastern University. Yeah.
And guess who's there having a grand old time? Adam Kuperstein. Hi.
Hey, Jackie, Trina, it is a great time. These students came out in full force. I was just talking to some of the students that are in student government over here. You know, Nova Southeastern University, 70-plus on-campus clubs. They have a lot of fun here. When they're not in class, they, of course, like to go to the beach, spend time in the water. But listen to this. There are some students at Nova Southeastern that actually do that as part of their studies. Check it out. These college students truly plunge into their studies.
We're going out to study one of our coral nurseries.
This is video of graduate students at Nova Southeastern University. They're part of the oceanography program. And on this day, they're checking the condition of coral after Tropical Storm Isaac passed through.
Our coral reefs are really one of our prime economic engines.
And that's part of the reason Nova Southeastern just built this, the largest coral reef center in America in Dania Beach.
Anytime you're on the cutting edge of any type of experiment or research, it's very exciting.
Inside the Center of Excellence for Coral Reef Ecosystems Research, we found students examining the effects of the BP oil spill on crustaceans. Other students cultivating coral in an aquarium.
And this is something that we would start with, a coral this size.
Carrie O'Neill says they started with 50 small ones and now have 250, the size of a basketball.
I've worked in the aquarium industry for a long time, and it's something I've always dreamed of, to be able to grow corals and actually use them for restoration.
The students and professors at Nova's Coral Reef Research Center love what they do, but they also recognize how critical this work is all over the world, but especially here in South Florida.
Protecting our reefs means protecting our beaches from severe coastal erosion and also protecting our fisheries and our food source and our tourism industry.
On in a second, I'm just gonna do a bump for what's
that
coming up.
The Reef Research Center has a grand opening coming up in 2 weeks, a $50 million facility. It is the largest in the entire country, something we're really proud of here at Nova Southeastern University. Now, something else is really cool. These students have already started using social media to get the word out, to show their spirit. We're using our hashtag NSUon6 on Twitter and on Instagram with College Week on 6. So that's how we're doing it here on College Week. Stop number three at Nova Southeastern. I actually just got to meet some of the basketball team, the women's basketball team here. Some great athletics programs. In fact, I'm a little worried because they're almost as tall as we are.
Yeah, well, they're very good here in a lot of different sports. 17 different programs here that they have, a national championship team and an Olympian. And we're going to be talking to that Olympian coming up in sports.
I can't wait to learn more about the sports here at Nova Southeastern. We're going to send it back inside the studio for now. For Joe Rose and Adam Kuperstein, seeing a few.
Okay, Adam and Joe, thanks. And tomorrow, by the way, our College Week Tour takes us to Miami-Dade College. We'll be live at 5 from the Kendall campus. You can start tweeting about it using the hashtag MiamiDadeCollegeOn6.
Plus, I'm Joe Rose. The Nova Southeastern Sports Department is very, very good. We're going to be talking to an Olympic swimmer and find out more about the sports department when we come back. Stay with us.
Oh, yeah. This is Nova Southeastern University, where the kids are happy and cheering as we continue our College Week here on NBC6.
And that's where we find NBC6 sports anchor Joe Rose, who now has become a DJ as well. You were spinning tunes. What's going on, Joe?
Houston Astros is one of three major leaguers from NSU, and they also have an Olympian on their swim team, the school's first ever Olympian, Esau Simpson, who joins me right now from the 100 meter from Grenada, back from the Olympics. I got to ask you, what was that whole experience like, being over there, now coming back and being a student?
It was ridiculous just to feel the sheer magnitude of competition with all the big guys like Michael Phelps, you know, Nathan Age, and all these big sprinters that I have to step up to and compete with. It was fantastic, man. And then to come back here and start school with all my schoolmates again, it's so encouraging to start a new collegiate season and just get back into it.
Well, we don't know a lot about the sports program here. Talk about the swimming. Something you said is doing really well here. Talk about it.
Really great. Brand new program, 2 years strong. Back-to-back men's conference championships. Brand new women's conference championship as of last year. And we're just going for nationals now. Nationals is on our list, and we're ready to do it.
I can see the school pride you have here. It's been great to see everybody out here. What's it like? Did everybody recognize you when you came back after your Olympic experience?
Yeah, definitely. A lot of people say hi in mornings and everything. Definitely a lot of shark pride in the room. Definitely. So it's just great to be back.
I want to ask you, go back for the Olympics, and you're 21, only 21.
Yeah, only 21.
Expect to be back in 4 years to go back for the next Summer Olympics.
Rio 2016, for sure, I'm there. I'm trying my best to make it back. God hoping, I'll be there.
Talk about the school itself, the school, the academics. Is it what you expected it to be?
It's great. It's structured and built for you to succeed. When you come here as a freshman, you're built here, you're here to succeed. You already succeeded just coming here. You just got to follow through throughout the years in academics as well as athletics.
Esau, thank you so much for being with us.
Man.
Wanted to make sure, congratulations on your swimming
career. Thank you very much.
Great to have you with us here. We're going to go ahead and throw it back. Ladies, take away. We got a lot more on sports coming up in just a few minutes. Stay with us.
Okay,
thank you, Joe.
Thanks.
He's having a real good time out there.
He's having too much of a good time out there.
He's always having a really good time.
And you know, he doesn't have to keep his day job because he's a pretty good DJ.
He is.
What a turnout here at Nova Southeast University in Davie. It's day three of College Week on NBC6. And coming up, we'll tell you why these students are boasting about one of the busiest dental clinics in the country and one of the most affordable for you. That's ahead.
College Week continues here at NBC6 South Florida.
Today we're featuring Nova Southeastern University. Adam Kuperstein joins us live from their campus in Davie with more. It's a great campus.
It's a beautiful campus, Jackie. I got some time on campus before we started here. And these students are so energetic, and they're also really bright, and they're helping our community too. Do you know this? 7,000 students in Nova Southeastern are studying some sort of health profession, and they're becoming our future nurses and physical therapists. And on top of that, there's a med school here, there's a dental school here, and South Floridians are so proud because that dental school is helping them save some money. Here's how. More than 24,000 patients visit this clinic every year. 185,000 procedures, everything from root canals to dentures. There are 172 dental chairs, and that makes it one of the largest and busiest dental clinics in the entire country. Now, patients here say they get the extra attention of professors and students working on their case together, and those procedures generally cost about half the price of what they would at a private dental office.
Because a lot of these patients don't have the private insurance that most people do have, so it makes it very affordable, and it makes the experience much more rewarding because you know that you're serving patients who otherwise wouldn't, you know, get that service they need.
They explain more, and they really tell you what they're going to do and explain you the cost, and you know, you can spread it out all along with your, you know, the time that you're in here, so you don't have to pay it all up front. I think it's great.
Now, NSU's dental school is a dual admit program, which means that they are students here guaranteed a spot as long as they complete on any of that dental program. Also, it helps them with the stress of having to apply to dental schools outside of Northern all across the country. Now, something else we caught up with here at Nova Southeastern University at Davie is the business school, and they're very proud of this. The MBA program is the largest in the state here at Nova, and here I'm going to tell you a little bit about it. We found this fascinating. The school is attracting more and more students who aren't necessarily interested in majoring in business. You see, the Huizinga Sales Institute is a place where they can get to perfect the technique of closing a deal. They can even study their own moves on camera as they do it. A lot of students here say they're learning how to sell themselves better during a job interview, or even how to become more effective asking for a raise. That's always important. Also, how you can earn a bachelor's, now you can earn a bachelor's degree in sales here at Nova Southeastern University. And we want to welcome in the president, George Hanbury, right now, who's live with us on campus. And big round of applause for the president. They like you over here. You can tell they're happy. They love their school. What is it? I keep hearing the students say they're so happy here. Why do you think that is?
Well, you know, you've talked about our great graduate and professional programs. That's 80% of our student body, 28,000 students. We have about 6,000 undergraduates, and these are some of the great undergraduate programs. Over 270 athletes, 3,000 first-time in college students, which means our classrooms are small.
I just read the stat, an average classroom size, 22. That is small.
Yes, less than 20 to 22 per classroom. Individual attention. As a private not-for-profit, we do want to nurture. Our number one interest is the student, and that's one of our values.
We showed earlier that Coral Reef Research Center, a beautiful facility, grand opening coming up. How proud are you? A $50 million facility just opening.
$50 million there. We're getting ready to spend another $100 million so that by 2020 we'll have over $300 million of extended funded research coming into Broward County and Nova Southeastern University. We see the place as not only a great educational institution, but part of the knowledge-based industry that a university can be and should be.
And on top of that, your students, I know they have fun out here, that's for sure.
They do. Go Sharks and fins up, everybody.
That's a good look from the president right there. President Hanbury, thank you so much for your time.
Thanks, Adam.
Thanks for being part of College Week. It's really been great to have you guys here. Fins up. Can we get that one more time? Fins up for everybody on NBC6. There it is. That's the Sharks of Nova Southeastern University. We'll be back with more on NBC6's College Week coming up next.
Day three of NBC6 College Week takes us to Nova Southeastern University.
Adam Kuperstein is spending the afternoon on campus in Davie. He joins us now live once again, and he has a preview of what's coming up tomorrow, Adam.
Yeah, Jackie, it's been a lot of fun. Great host here at Nova Southeastern University. We went indoors because of some rain outside, and tomorrow we're heading south to Kendall. We'll be at Miami-Dade College. We visited a number of their campuses to tell you some great stories, including how some students hope to make it big in Hollywood, and they believe that that road to success starts at Miami-Dade's new state-of-the-art production studios. That's in North Dade. It's a dream come true for film students, actors, and even their music students. Now, that's going to be fun. Back out here in Davie at Nova Southeastern University. We're encouraging people to tweet. You're tweeting right now, right? Yeah. Using the hashtag NSUon6. Last chance for Nova students and alums to get on Twitter and use the hashtag NSUon6, or on Instagram, post your pictures showing your spirit for your school at College Week on 6. That's a wrap for College Week Day 3. We'll see you tomorrow, Day 4, at Miami-Dade College. Take care.
And hello, everybody, and welcome back. I'm Joe Rose, live here at Nova Southeastern University. They've got a sports program that they're very proud of. We're joined by Mike Mominey, the athletic director. Hey, Mike, just talk about how proud you are, the championships, and what you guys have been able to accomplish in a short period of time.
Well, it's been a great run, Joe. First of all, I'm happy you guys are out here, and we could really promote our program. But, you know, we have 17 different teams here at Nova Southeastern. We compete at the NCAA Division II level, Sunshine State Conference. But, you know, we've had the great fortune to win 5 national championships and 19 conference championships just in the last 8 years.
All right, and on top of that, also, you guys have a lot of famous alum here as well that people aren't aware of.
They are, and on the athletic side, you know, we do have 3 former baseball players playing at the major league level. Most recently, Mike Fiers, who's a pitcher for the Brewers, just pitched against our Marlins down here. And we also have Sandra Chankeja. She was a 4-time national champion, and she's out on the LPGA Tour. So we're also proud of our alumni.
You and I were talking earlier. The location here it's safe, but the pride of what you've been able to get from your men and women's teams here have been fantastic.
There is, and I think it starts with the students, Joe, and I think you guys got to experience that today, and we have such support all the way up from our Board of Trustees, President George Hanbury, most importantly the students, because you know, we're a student-based organization, and of course student-athletes have done such a great job representing us on and off the field.
This has been one of the best-kept secrets we've had. What you guys have been able to do is we take a look here at some of the different things you guys have coming up here. You have a lot of sports teams playing right now.
We do. We have two soccer games going on tonight. So the women are probably at halftime in there against Florida Southern. So we opened up conference tonight in our men's and women's soccer. And then we also have volleyball opening up on Friday against Lynn University up in Boca Raton. So it's we're off and running, and we look forward to a great year this year.
Mike, thank you so much for spending some time with us. Razor the Shark, you look fantastic. By the way, we're not done here. We're going to let you know that the Miami Dolphins, who also are here on this facility, have a big football game coming up against the Raiders. Courtney Fallon has this report. And that's going to do it from here. Razor, my friend the Shark, wants to say goodbye. Ladies, take it away here.
All right.
Fins up. Fins up, Joe.
Joe, love the shirt. Just, I mean, it's so you.
Although maybe he should get it a size larger. No, just kidding.
It doesn't have to fit on his head.
I've never seen him so casual, by the way. Spinning away.
Oh, he's having a good time.
Oh, yeah, spinning some tunes.